If you didn't get a stimulus check or you got the wrong amount, stay tuned. I'm going to explain why and show you what you can do to fix it. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Min. I talk about personal finance, investing, and how to build wealth. If you haven't already, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Let's get into the video. All right, guys, so we're on the week of April 20th, and a lot of people already got their stimulus check, and I know a lot of you guys have not gotten yours. So I'm gonna explain to you guys what's going on and what you can do to potentially get yours a little bit quicker. So if you got the wrong amount, just remember that the IRS is using your 2019 tax return. And if you didn't file one, they're using your 2018. So you might have to go back and look at your tax return to see what you actually filed as. And if you don't remember, well, now's a good time to go look at that so you can actually see. But just know that if you got your stimulus check already, 15 days after that, the IRS is actually gonna send you a letter explaining how they calculated everything and what you're supposed to be getting. And they're also gonna leave some information in there on how you can fix it if it wasn't correct. So just to remind you guys, each qualifying American is supposed to get $1,200, and then for every child under 17, you get an additional $500. And so if your child was 17, then that child doesn't qualify, just to be clear. They have to be 16 and under. Now, if you're married, you can get up to $2,400, and then the same applies with a child. It's $500 per child under 17. Now, one thing that might be confusing is if you had a child, let's say in 2019 or 2020, and you actually didn't file your taxes and the IRS doesn't know about that child, you won't get that $500. You actually have to wait. If you had a child in 2019, you should definitely file a 2019 tax return so that child actually will get claimed on that tax return. If you don't, then the IRS is gonna go back to 2018 and you're gonna lose out on about $500. So just make sure you do that. Now, you don't actually lose it, you'll just have to wait for it. If you file your taxes in 2021 for your 2020 year, then you're gonna get that $500 at that time. So that might explain why some of you are getting different amounts. I know that some of you may not be getting the right amount even after all of that. So just wait for your letter in the mail and then see if you can fix it with the IRS. Just follow the instructions that they give you in the letter. Now, no one has seen this letter because it's only been about a week, so you might have to wait until next week to see this letter. Now, if some of you got too much money, well, most likely they're gonna take that money back. I know some people got like $8 million or something ridiculous like that, and then a couple days later it disappeared. So don't go and spend that money just yet. Maybe just wait it out and see what happens. Now, if the IRS ends up not taking that money back, then good for you. You can probably keep it. They probably won't ask for it back. But just remember, if you end up doing your 2020 taxes, they might actually do a true up and calculate what your actual tax credit is and might actually make you pay it back. So just keep that in mind. Now, what happens if you didn't get your stimulus check yet? So there are some of you that are out there that qualify for the stimulus that haven't gotten it yet. And that's because, remember, that last week's round of stimulus only went to tax filers that had bank information on file. And so if they did their 2018 or 2019 taxes and they actually put a direct deposit banking information in there, then the IRS already knew who you were, and those were the people that got their stimulus first. Now, for some of you, you have to wait a little bit longer, and maybe this week is the week that it's gonna happen. This is the week of the 20th of April, and they're most likely doing another batch right now, and most of those people will probably have to wait till Wednesday the 22nd to see that. But if you are a Social Security recipient, they actually didn't give the date for when they're actually gonna give that stimulus out. And also for railroad retirements and disability, you probably won't be getting it at the same time. And so you kind of have to wait for the IRS to give us an update. And so if you're in that camp, just be patient, check the IRS website and watch the news and see what the Secretary of Treasury is saying. He hasn't actually given a date yet. The only thing he said so far was that it's going to be immediately after the tax filers. And he actually didn't even say a date. And so it could be this week, it could be next week. Now, another reason why you may not be getting your stimulus yet is the fact that the IRS probably doesn't have your banking information on file. And this is actually a pretty common problem, and I'll talk a little bit about this later. But if they don't have your banking information on file, then go ahead and go to the IRS website. There is a Get My Payment link that you can click on, and you can enter some of your information in and actually update your banking information there, assuming that the website actually works. Now, it seems like most of the times when you go and enter information in there, it just gives you a status not available message or something like that, and it ends up not working. Just remember that the IRS is updating the information every day to that website. So as people are kind of entering new information in and non-filers are entering information in through the other portal, they're actually going and adding that information into the database every day. So you kind of have to be patient. And speaking of that, if you didn't file a tax return in 2018 or 2019, then the IRS doesn't even know you exist, so you need to go to their website. They have a new web portal where you can enter your information directly with them rather than going to TurboTax. Now, I know in my other video I told you guys to go to TurboTax. That was what was available at the time. Now, if you haven't already done that, then you can actually go to this new website. I'll put a link in the description and I'll show you what it looks like on the screen here, and you can go enter your information there. It's not clear when you're gonna get your stimulus, but just enter it there so that way it's already there and it's ready for the next batch. And earlier I mentioned the direct deposit banking information. So there's a lot of problems right now with a lot of people who have used third-party tax preparers to do their taxes. And what I mean by that is people are using TurboTax or H&R Block or Jackson Hewitt. These are like the, you know, tax preparer facilities that are in your local city and you're going there to do your taxes. So what's happening right now is a lot of you guys, when you guys did your taxes, you got a upfront tax refund. It's basically an advance that the tax prep company gave you instead of you waiting for the IRS to actually deposit the money into your account. And so when they did this, what ended up happening was they set up all of these, you know, intermediate bank accounts that would kind of fund you your tax refund so you can get it immediately, you know, which makes sense if you need the money. And so then the IRS would refund them back into that intermediate bank account. And what's happening right now is all of the stimulus checks are actually going to those bank accounts. And so H&R Block and you know, TurboTax and Jackson Hewitt, they've all made statements about this already. And they told the IRS that, hey, this is what's going on. You need to go and get the actual direct deposit information, which they say is available. So the IRS is probably correcting this right now. And so if you're in this camp where you're actually using one of these third-party tax preparer companies, then most likely that's where your stimulus check is. It's actually, you know, gone to this bank account, which shouldn't actually go there because the names don't match with the names that are on file. So it should actually be rejected. And so worst case, if things don't happen quickly and the IRS doesn't fix this by this week, then you're just gonna end up probably going in the April 24th, you know, checks. So hopefully they fix this so that way you can get your money direct deposited. You definitely don't wanna go the check route because the check route actually will take longer because they have income restrictions. They're sending out checks to the low income earners first, and then you might actually be way down there, you know, way later in May or something like that. So you definitely don't wanna be in that camp. Now, one thing you can do is you can go to that Get My Payment website and you can enter your information in, and hopefully your information is on file because you can actually go there and update your banking information directly. And that's assuming that they didn't process the payment already, and you can actually see the status of that on that website if it's available. So you should definitely go through that website through irs.gov. I'll leave a link down below and make sure you check your status. And if it isn't processed yet, go ahead and see if you can update your banking information to your current banking information, because who knows when they're gonna fix this problem with the third-party companies. And it's better just to put your bank information in there so that way they can just reprocess it the next chance that they get. Now, let's say you go to the Get My Payment website, you enter your information in, and it says payment status not available. Well, that can mean a couple things, and I'll read it off for you here. This is directly off the IRS website. It just means that you may have not finished filing your 2019 tax return, or they don't have a 2018 tax return on file. The application doesn't yet have your data. So like I mentioned earlier, the IRS is updating this data every day. And so you may just have to check every day to see if that information is uploaded yet. Another reason could be that you actually don't need to file a tax return. So you need to go to the other link and actually enter your information in for non-filers. And I'll leave a link down in the description for you below. Now, they did say that some of this information actually should show up into the Get My Payment web portal, but it takes time for them to process that data. Remember that people are entering in that non-filer data in daily as they kind of figure this out, because a lot of people actually didn't even know they got a stimulus until somebody probably told them. And so that information that people are entering in probably hasn't been processed yet. You know, you would assume it would be automatic and it would just, you know, automatically update to the website, but I don't think things work that way, especially when you're working this fast and you're trying to get a lot of entries in. I mean, we have over 300 million people in the US, and so, you know, things can take some time to update. Now, another reason why the Get My Payment may not work is because you actually are a Social Security recipient or SSI or VA benefits or disability. The website actually doesn't work for you guys. You guys actually just have to wait. And so they have to work out that information with those entities to make sure that they have your latest information. And then eventually you're gonna get some money either direct deposit or through a paper check. And the last reason why the Get My Payment may not work is because you're actually not eligible. And so I talked a little bit about this last time, but I'll give you a quick list of why you may not be eligible. You know, you may have made too much money. Remember, if you're single, you have to make $75,000 to get the full amount. And if you start making $99,000 and over, you actually phase out and you get nothing. And if you're married, just double all those numbers. And if you're head of household, it's $136,500. And so if you made any more than that, then you're not gonna get any stimulus check. Another very common reason why you didn't get a stimulus is because you were actually claimed as a dependent on somebody else's tax return. And so if you were a child or a college student, your parents may have claimed you already. Even though you're working, it doesn't really matter. They could still claim you as a dependent because, you know, they're providing for you. And so that would make you ineligible for the stimulus. And so you can ask your parents or somebody for a portion of their stimulus to make up for it. Another reason why you wouldn't get a stimulus is if you were a non-resident alien. And so if you were an undocumented worker, you actually wouldn't qualify. And this is another reason, if you were past due on your child support and it was actually reported to the federal agencies, then you wouldn't be eligible for a stimulus check either. All right, guys, so those are some of the reasons why you wouldn't get a stimulus check, or maybe you got the wrong amount. Just keep in mind that the IRS may not have all your information. So check on that Get My Payment page and enter some of your information. Make sure it is from the irs.gov website. One thing I want to point out is there are a lot of scammers out there right now that will try to get your information. They may send you text messages, they may email you, they may, you know, even walk right up to your door and tell you that, you know, this is why you're not getting your stimulus, we need your information. Just remember, those people might be trying to get your information so they can claim your stimulus into their bank account. And so you got to be careful about that. Now, the irs.gov website has the non-filer link, which goes to a very fishy website, and I'll put it up on my screen so you know, but it actually isn't fishy. This is their website, and you can trust it because it actually came from irs.gov. And then also the Get My Payment page is actually from the IRS website, so you don't have to worry about that one. And so there you have it. And if you got the wrong amount, just remember the IRS is gonna send you a letter in a couple days here, and you can take a look at that letter and see how they determine your stimulus. And you don't have to pay it back. This is just an explanation on how they calculated that number that they gave you. And if it's wrong for whatever reason, make sure you go and use the information on that letter to try to fix it so you can get the right amount. And just remember, if you had children in 2020 or 2019, if you didn't file your 2019 taxes, just remember that you're probably gonna get that tax credit when you file your 2020 taxes in 2021. Alright guys, if you found this video helpful, please hit the like button down below. Share it with a friend. They may have the same questions as you if they haven't got their stimulus yet. And if you like videos like this, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll be doing more videos about this in the future, so if you guys have any questions, leave a comment down below. And as always, have a nice day and stay safe out there.